Adnan, how is the networking arena shifting from a proprietary and complex model to an open networking ecosystem, and why is that shift happening?
Yeah, thank you for the question. I think what is happening in the industry is that because of the innovation and what cloud has done for the infrastructure, people are looking to build their private cloud infrastructure on the same principles as what the public cloud guys have done. And in order for you to basically drive towards a more agile infrastructure from a private cloud standpoint and also drive the cost points down, this is what is driving the fundamental shift in the networking industry. We believe that the networking industry is following the same model that compute has followed, from a standardization on x86, moving from proprietary vertically integrated mainframe kind of a model to merchant silicon on the networking side, and traditionally networking was a vertically integrated platform where, you know, hardware from one person, software from one person, and then support and services from the same company. What Dell has done is very unique, and we're the only vendor that started this effort, is by giving customers a choice of the operating system that they can run on their platform.
Okay, yeah, that's another question I was going to make, is how is Dell moving to attend this trend?
So we basically stepped back, and the interesting thing is the networking use cases are fairly broad. You require different things depending on what kind of business applications and the market that you're in from a customer standpoint. So we looked at the ecosystem and we picked four operating system or four solutions to bring to the market. We started with Cumulus, which is Linux, then Big Switch, which is OpenFlow controller-based model, IP Infusion, bringing MPLS on Dell networking hardware, and then Pluribus, that is a fabric without a controller model. But the interesting thing in all of this is it is the same hardware. And given your use case and an environment, you can pick the right solution and deploy it. That never existed in the networking world before for customers and the enterprises.
Great. And have customers already realized these benefits? I mean, are they adopting and moving towards this open network?
Yeah. So our traction has been, we have over, in the last 9 months, we have over 400 paying customers worldwide. That's tremendous growth for Dell Networking. We have seen successes in all segments of the market, starting from large telco providers to big financial institutions to even government organizations across the globe. So it is better than what we expected, and we have accelerated our R&D efforts into the area. We have staffed teams up faster than we had planned. So for us, it's very exciting times.
And earlier today, you talked about treating networking environments as a platform. So what exactly does that mean, and why can it be so important and helpful for companies?
Yeah, I think if you take a look at what happened on the compute side, it is the fact that the application ecosystem thrived once compute became a platform. You could develop applications on top of it. Today, nothing like this exists on the networking world. So we took the first step in working towards a similar standard as x86 exists on the compute side by Dell jointly contributed a standard with Microsoft and Facebook to the OCP project in February of this year. And then by giving customers a pure Linux operating system that can run any Linux application, it's enabling platform very similar to what compute exists. So customers can leverage the Linux ecosystem that exists to run any kind of an application they believe it is right for their environment. Traditionally, they couldn't do that, even with ROS back in the day.
And besides these benefits you've already mentioned, do these changes mean protection of investment in networking? And how can companies benefit from the open networking and software-driven?
I think that's a great question. The challenge that we see a lot of enterprise customers facing is how do they get to SDN from where they are today? Because it requires training of resources, it will take time. You have legacy applications. So what Dell has done is that with Dell Networking, you can start with Dell operating system, and given your use case or whichever road you want to pick for SDN, you can change the operating system on the platform. You don't have to rip and replace, and your hardware capital investments are protected. So you can move at your pace as your team evolves, as you train your team, and which solution you pick, because it will take time. I mean, people have to test, they have to train their resources, and that's how we basically make sure our customer investments are protected.